Song.
So I didn't expect for this to be a series, yet here we are. And just as I couldn't wall ride before my wall ride video, and I couldn't Matty flip before my Matty flip video, I can't trippy spin. And that's what we're gonna learn today, the inverted orbit slash trippy spin. And that's an important distinction to make. See, what we're talking about, with the regular orbit, we're rotating around an object, keeping it dead center screen. We're just kind of holding a turn, and that's a valuable trick everybody should learn. What we're doing with an inverted orbit is flipping our quad upside down. But now because the rotor disc is facing down, the quad wants to pull down to the ground, which means we need to angle up and in the direction of the turn. And as a result, our object as we're flying is gonna be kinda diagonally centered if we're doing it right, and if our camera angle is matching the speed at which we're moving. Here's where the controversy lies though. What we're talking about is an inverted orbit. First person to really codify the term trippy spin was Florence Roque. And when he did his trippy spin, he would do a regular orbit, but he would include right-handed aileron rolls in the move. And that's what he called the trippy spin. Later on, when Ledrib was doing a video or working on his inverted orbit, I don't know exactly what happened, he thought it looked trippy. And he called it a trippy spin. And because Ledrib had a bigger platform, the inverted orbit that we're talking about is not the original trippy spin, which now leaves all of the power in your hands. Because you could either be that guy that is going to correct everybody and say, oh, that inverted orbit is not a trippy spin, or you could just watch FPV and love it and make sure you're getting out there and flying because it's fun as hell. So let's get a couple disclaimers out of the way. Those of you who are prone to motion sickness may have a very hard time watching this video. The trippy spin is purposefully a disorienting move and it may cause some discomfort. Use that information at your own discretion. Secondly, I'm not claiming to know how to do this trick. That's not what this is about. However, I watched Bubby's video, and I watched Drib's video, and I watched JB's video, and I watched the NTT videos, and I watched every tutorial I could find on the trippy spin. And hopefully, if I can distill that information down to you in a way that helps you figure out how this trick works, then we'll be successful. I am admittedly nervous about this trick. Not only is it a trick that kicks the ass of a lot of pilots, it's also just one where so much of the trick is blind. All right, so here's my spot. I got a post. And I'm gonna trippy spin it. Or at least I'm gonna try to. So, or maybe that's too close. I'll get the other one so you're not getting so much motor noise. Yeah, that's gonna be easier for us to talk. Okay, so the interesting, or the most interesting part about every tutorial I've seen for the trippy spin is how people get into the trippy spin. Because my first thought with the trippy spin, like, ooh, is not to do that. But is to come at it like a turn, which means come at it with some momentum. So I'm coming at it like this, and then I'm gonna go knife edge, nose up, and try to catch it, and get into the orbit. Whew! Okay, that was real close. And that's what Drib did in his tutorial, that's what JB did in his tutorial, that's what NTT did in his tutorial. Ooh, see, I lost it there. But I actually think there's a better way, and Bubby thinks there's a better way too, because if you come up at it like a stall, that was a bonk. Totally meant to do that. Come in it like a stall, then it's way, way easier to start to mess with your momentum, right? Stall. And I lost the target. And both my sticks are going out right now as I rotate to the right. Okay, that was not garbage. Let me see if I can do it again. Come up. Yeah, I think it was Rue FPV that made the good point that any orbit that you do takes more throttle than you think you do. Do it once more on the right, because that seems to be my preferred side. plenty of throttle. Ugh, see, and I wasn't going in a circle, or my circle wasn't, the center of my circle was not at the post. So let's come back up. Here's our stall, here's our flip, here's our trip. I would call that a trippy spin. You know, maybe not the most exciting, but now let's really ruin our day. And try it on the left. Ooh, okay. Ha ha! Oh, what a drummer. I have a stupid left hand. Okay. That was a joke for all my drummers. Ooh, okay. That was not as bad as I thought it was, but I'm really hoping that working at it from the left is just gonna make it, like, there's gonna be the ambidextrous training, and it will be better on the right if I can get it less bad on the left. Whew, that was real close. Coming at a trippy spin with momentum is really hard. Yeah. That's just, like, or even to do, is a trippy turn a thing? Is a trippy turn a thing? Is that a thing that people do? Can I make that happen? No, without going up. I don't know how I can keep it. Seems like success comes from the stall. Hell yeah, that's a fucking trippy spin. Hell yeah, hell yeah. Woo! Got him so high up on the throttle for that. Okay. Yeah, Rue is right. Okay. Woo! Oh, that just ejected the battery. Oh, I just watched that bounce halfway across the field. Go get that. Okay, battery. Fine shape. Not bad. Good job, Chris Rosser. I'm gonna shut that up though. I can trippy spin, I can trippy spin. Hey, like and subscribe down below. If you like the I Can't series, go ahead and comment. Tell me what trick you'd like to see me get my ass kicked by next. If you want to support the channel, I'm on Patreon. Until then, enjoy the rip. Can't help it.
Crawls right back up and bites me, and I'm back.
Can't help it, the girl can't help it.